Tom Basil.
And Jason Levine.
Today we're taking a look at Shot and Totten. Shot and Totten is a game here from Yellow, but this is not the original version of this game, from Rainer Knizia. This is a reprint of Battle Line. Battle Line from GMT Games was a reprint of Shot and Totten.
Yes, it's a reprint of a reprint of a reprint.
Well, I mean, but really it is, because Shot and Totten came out, and it was a game about Scots people fighting over different clan rocks. And then GMT took it and put it into some soldier Punic Wars type thing.
Yes.
But then they added some tactics cards, which some people didn't like, some people did. And then Shot and Totten is actually a copy of Battle Line with that addition added to it. Let me show you how it plays. There are 9 stones in the middle of the table. Your goal is to claim 5 of those 9 stones, any 5, or 3 that are adjacent to each other. And you're going to do that by playing cards by the stones. There's a deck of cards, and these cards are numbered from 1 to 9 in 6 different colors, so there's 54 cards in the deck. And you're going to have 6 cards in your hand, and on your turn, you are going to play a card in front of one of the stones somewhere, and you can have up to 3 cards in front of any one stone. Once a card is placed there, that card is there permanently, and then you'll draw another card. When both players have played 3 cards on their side, you're going to compare them. Now, the order of the cards does not matter. All right, so, for example, here, this is a 189 and this is a 238. There's nothing special about these sets of cards, so the high card would win, in which case this player would win because they have a 9. But there is a hierarchy of what things win. The highest possible thing that you can have is a straight in one color. So here we have a 4, 5, 6. Remember, order doesn't matter in purple. So the only thing that could beat a 4, 5, 6 in purple would be maybe a 5, 6, 7 in something else, or 6, 7, 8, something along those lines. The second highest thing is 3 numbers of the same type. So if my opponent here played 3 2s, I would beat him with 3 4s. But if he played a 1, 2, 3 of red, he would beat me. Just underneath 3 of a kind is 3 of the same color. So having 3 reds here is not as good as having 3 of a kind, but hey, it's something. And then underneath that is a straight. So here we have a 5, 6, 7. Now the most powerful thing is the straight of one color, but a straight of a run of basically 3 numbers is better than having just numbers here, which would then come to the sum. So here I have 13. So that's how you play the game. You're going to be, once you have this, then you would basically put this stone on your side to show that you control it once the cards are there. Now, you need 3 cards on both sides to claim victory. However, if you can prove your opponent cannot win, then you can claim a side. So let's say, for example, I have 3 2s over here, and they have a 7 and an 8 over here. Well, it doesn't matter what they add to that side, because they can make that a run of a 6, 7, 8, but they cannot make that a run which can beat me. The only thing I can beat 3 of a kind is a color run, and there's a little reference card that shows us this. So they cannot win here. So on my turn, I can claim this. Or maybe they have 2 8s over here. Well, obviously 3 8s could beat 3 2s, but if I can show that the other 4 8s have already been played on the table, then there's no possible way they can get another 8 there, which means I can win. So there's this kind of proof here that you can play. And that's it. You're just going to go back and forth until one player claims 5 stones, or another player claims, or one of the players claims 3 stones in a row. There's also a deck of tactics cards. You do not have to use these in a game. If you do, you will have a handful of 7 cards. You'll start with one of these cards, and these cards will all do different things. For example, this one here is simply a 7. This one here can be a 1, 2, or 3. Each one, there's a joker card here, which basically can be anything that you want. And so you have these different cards or special cards. Well, you can play a tactic card on your turn, but you can never play more than one tactic card than your opponent has. So if I play a joker on my side and my opponent plays no tactic cards, well, then I cannot play any more tactic cards because I've played my one and he's played zero. But if he plays one, then I can play another one. So on your turn, you'll play one of these tactic cards or you'll play one of the clan cards that people have. And when you draw back up, you can draw from either pile. So it adds a little bit of variety to the normal game. Okay, well, me and Jason are going to disagree and agree here, I bet. Okay, here's where we disagree. I love this new artwork. I love it.
I think it's okay. I usually love yellow artwork, but this, it's all over the place. Like, some factions look really nice. The ones that look like they came right out of the movie Brave are gorgeous. But then other factions just don't look as nice to me. But
well, they look very...
Yeah.
It's ridiculous artwork, but I love ridiculous artwork.
But I do think the artwork, I mean, the artwork's incredibly drawn. It's just some of it isn't my style artwork.
Is it better than Battle Line from GMT?
Of course it is.
Which used clip art, basically.
Yes, I know that. Of course it is. Of course it is. It's just some of them look like skinny, crazy guys and don't look like Scott so much to me.
All right. Well, here's the thing. I've talked about Battle Line before. Battle Line is in my top 100 games of all time. I want to say it's pretty high in your... I don't know if it was in your top 100.
I think it was. I'm not sure. It was. If it wasn't, it was pretty close to being on it if it wasn't.
This is one of my favorite two-player card games of all time, hands down. And there's a couple reasons I really like playing it. One is I love the back-and-forth tension between the players. And, you know, whenever you play a card, you watch what your opponent plays and you're like, do they have the other five I'm looking for? But the second is, I love saying, you know what? You cannot win here. I love that whole aspect of being able to prove that it is impossible for my opponent to win at a certain spot. That's a really neat thing.
Yes.
And the game starts out slow. You're putting cards down, and you're putting your... Sometimes you're throwing cards away in a spot. Sometimes you're trying to win a spot, but you don't want to... You put a red five down. And in my hand, I have a red six. And I also have a purple five. Now, the purple 5 is probably easier for me to get another 5 out there. But then my opponent puts down a green 7, and I'm like, all right, what's he going to do next? And you're kind of like playing chicken. If he puts down a blue 8, I'm like, I got him with 2-3 fives. He's just going to do a straight. I can beat a straight with 3 fives. But if he puts down another one of the same color...
Exactly.
And sometimes I have two of the same color, but the third one I don't have, but I'll put down those two just to make my opponent sweat a bit. Of course, later on, they'll be like, oh, you put down the 1 and 2 in red, but notice the 3 reds over here, so...
You're out. Exactly. And it's very tactical in that way because each different formation, like how you put your cards, you put straights, straights of the same color, three of a kind, random numbers, flushes, and what you put really makes a difference because you can give up some. It's impossible to win everything, so you want to strategically pick the ones to win in this game.
Yeah, and I always go for the three in a row. I think three in a row is the way to do it because you want to pick those three that you think you can win. That's better than five. But, I mean, you know.
Yes.
Now, let me ask you this. Tactics or no tactics?
100% tactics.
Really? Have you played it without tactics?
Yes, I have. I played the original Shot and Totten.
I think it's fine without tactics, by the way, but I agree with Jason. I like tactics better.
Yeah, I mean, the tactics add that extra dimension where if it looks like someone's going to beat you, oh, I have a card which makes you get rid of one of your cards. So you have a 7, 8, 9 of purple, and all of a sudden I throw out that tactic card that gets rid of your 8, and now you have a 7 and 9, and you're sitting there going, what do I do? But then you pull out a tactic card that puts the extra 8, and you get the 7, 8, 9 back, and those tactic cards really change the feel of the game, because it's not just a card number counting game at that point. It also adds that extra level of manipulation.
Right, and just as an FYI, if let's say Jason has 3 8s out, and I have a 2 and a 4 of different colors, and he says, all right, well, I'm winning this one. There's no way you can win it. I can't say, well, no, if I use this tactic card to do this, I could still possibly use that tactic card to do that, but you're not allowed to use those when you're trying to prove that someone's wrong. And I think that's good, because that game would be too messy. It's a slight bit more random, a slight bit more chaotic with the tactic cards in. And when I first saw them, I was like, you're blowing up the purity of this game. And then I started playing with them, and I was like, oh, it's not so bad, because if you really don't want them to be played that badly, then don't play them.
Exactly.
And your opponent can only use one. But he'll use that one in such an irritating way that you'll go,
I need one now.
Fine, I'm playing one too.
Exactly. I always draw one just to hold it, but I try not to use it until I feel like I really need to use it. But I try not to use them because then if your opponent uses it, you kind of go, ha, you used one, now I'm going to keep going. And if you don't need to use one, it's better not to use one.
All right, well, what's your awesomeness rating here?
This one, I love it. Love the new edition. And I, you know, obviously if you like the yellow small box game, it definitely fits in and it's a great game. Awesomeness rating of 9.
Well, I'm in agreement with Jason. Awesomeness rating of 9 for sure. This is a game, there are many great two-player games. I like Lost Cities, Balloon Cup and all that. I think this is one of the best, if not the best, in that one. It's certainly one that I love playing. My wife and I play Lost Cities more than this, but I would prefer to play this one. I think it's excellent. I'm glad it's in a good version now. The GMT one's out of print. It also looks like it's a war game too, which throws people off. This one's, check this out. Yes, it's an old game, but it is a classic for a reason. I love it. I highly recommend Shot and Totten.
One of the best two-player games out there.
Thanks so much for watching the Dice Tower videos. Find more great videos and reviews, as well as our top-rated audio podcast at Dicetower.com. You can also find other great shows at Dicetowernetwork.com. I'm Eric Summerer, and you've been watching the Dice Tower. The Dice Tower is sponsored by Cool Stuff, Inc., where you can find great games for great prices. Cool stuff in stock. Check them out at CoolStuffInc.com.